Now that's a very unusual hat. Well, I wonder what's under a hat such as that. Well, it could be a creature they call a gazette that balances things on its head because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat. Or maybe a sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat!
I can see that you've got quite a mind for your ring. Why, one thing, and you drag me right off with a page. Now I'm here and there's no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me and a thinker like you. Think if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a kink with a sink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up together. Oh, the things you can't think when you think about Zeus.
Zeus!
On a ship, to the river, a bed, or to Salisbury.
Think of beautiful shop
with the cherry on top.
You don't need an excuse.
Oh, the things you can think when you think about Zeus.
Think of an elephant up in a tree.
Think of a person too tiny to see.
Think of a bird with a one feather tail.
Going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo sad to me.
Think of a general crazy for war.
Think of horrible and hairy.
Something sinister and scary that you never dared to think of before.
Think a glimmer of light.
Ah.
But I hope you're prepared to be scared of the scared.
As the same other moon.
Interest right on the brink
when you think about Zeus.
An unusual story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world. And a boy from that world who has things just like you.
Just think!
From the planet of Boo.
And the smallest of small.
To the jungle of New
Orleans. And the largest of all.
And think, and think, and think, and think, and think, and think.
Just think!
Oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare.
Oh, the things you can think.
When your things have run dry. In the blink of an eye. There's another thing there.
Bye.
lining up to get loose.
All the things you can think,
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 all the things you can think when you think about Zeus. When you think about Zeus. When you think about Zeus.
Our story begins with a very strange sound. The drums of a jungle beginning to pound. Now imagine a sky.
Well, I'll imagine bright blue.
It's the jungle of noon.
Well, near the river Walu.
Now think of an elephant lumbering through.
Horton!
Yes, Horton.
Horton hears a who.
On the 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the pool by the pool, he was splashing,
splash,
enjoying the jungle's great joys when Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
heard a small noise.
Oh, oh. So Horton stopped splashing. He looked toward the sound.
That's funny.
Thought Horton,
there's no one around.
He heard it again, just a very faint yell,
as if some tiny person were calling for help. I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked, he could see nothing now.
But a small speck of dust going past
through the air.
I say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that is able to yell. So you know what I think? I think there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear. He'll be blown in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him because, after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
Using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his great trunk through the air, and he lifted the dust speck and carried it over, placed it down
safe
on a very soft clover.
Huh!
person down there. And what's more, quite likely there's two, even three, even four.
Ha!
Let the boy!
Ha!
Down on that clover.
Hello? Who are you?
Well, we're who's here. We are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. We're who's who, sir. I'm a who and so is she. We're tiny little people blowing by in the air, wondering how and why. Here on Who, the tiniest planet in the sky.
La 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 la, Who, la la la.
We're Who's here, we or Who's here, struggling to stay alive. Each gust propels our gusto. How the heck do Who survive? Should be drowned, hitting the ground, oh my.
imagine the Who's unusual life.
Picture the tiniest houses and grocery stores.
Ooh.
With tiny umbrellas that drip on the tiniest floors.
Ooh.
The tiniest tunnels and tiniest streets. Miniature buses with miniature seats. Miniature buildings with miniature windows and doors.
No smaller town than yours.
We got a marching band that is small but grand.
Oh, you ought to hear them well.
That's my Christmas tale. Every whodunit Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not.
Woo!
Imagine a place that is tidy and totally clean.
Ooh.
Where even a Grinch wouldn't dare to be totally mean.
You think that is heaven on earth? Yes, you do.
But heaven on earth isn't heaven on who?
Troubles on who are the biggest that you've ever seen.
We're on the brink of war, they say.
We're going to war and oh my.
Cause if we do, then here on who?
Well, you can kiss Whoville goodbye.
Our skies are unbearable.
And war is unbearably near.
And that's not the end of our troubles here.
For on the other side of town, the truck in the trees were all cut down. They once stood tall in all their glory. Another story.
So here on who we live in fear. We're drifting through space and cannot steer. A troubled and a tiny land. Our future's in your hands. It's up to you, sir.
I won't let you fall. A person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
An invisible world, oh amazing but true. We'll leave Horton to listen and we'll zoom in on who. But guess who enters the story now?
Who?
You! Meet a tiny Who family on a small rainy day.
Mom and Dad are just home from the Who PTA.
And here's their son, JoJo.
In trouble again.
Cause his things take him places where no one has been.
I'm the mayor of Who, why I've just been elected, and upright behavior is thus forth expected.
And we've just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You invented new things which defy all description.
You gave Miss O'Dooley a nervous conniption.
Your thinks were so wild they disrupted your classes, and even made Miss McElhoo drop her new glasses, which is why you're suspended. Yes, that's what they said. Young man, what and who has got into your head? Now Horton has found us. We are safe on a clover. But clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you, yes, dear. But couldn't you try thinking just a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed. And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away.
All right. I'll be going. First, let me say, all the things you can think.
Stop!
All the things you can think.
Be quiet.
Splash and you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you sit there and scrub, have a think in that tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor leading up to a shore where the water is cool. Soon your tub's not a tub.
It's McGilligan's pool. This might be a pool like I read of in books, connected to one of those underground brooks, an underground river that starts here and flows right under the bathtub, and then who knows? It's possible. Anything's possible. It might go along down where no one can see. Understate Highway 203, right under the wagon, right under the toes, a Mrs. Lombroso who's hanging out clothes. It's possible, anything's possible.
It's possible, anything's possible.
This might be a river, now mightn't it be connecting the Gallagher's pool with the sea? Then maybe some fish might be swimming toward me.
Overflowed on the floor. The water is running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You flooded the den. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you come tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, I'm not trying to hog it.
He was mine.
must both lay down the law.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a shout? Who has the instructions on how to raise a shout? Who has all the answers? I don't know.
Does your child give you troubles? Do his grades keep on shrinking?
Does he drive teachers wild with his uncontrolled thinking?
As a parent, are you overwhelmed, insecure? The help that you seek is inside this brochure.
It's night, sun, rise and shine, sun. It's a very special day.
Get dressed, dear. Look your best, dear. Soon you will be on your way.
Now here is your pencil.
Here are your mittens.
Here is your sword.
My sword?
I'm General Genghis Kong Schmitz, and I scare children out of their wits. But you'll see with a good answer, my school is the answer for shakers and dreamers and two wits. And in this case, I'd say the shoe fits. Chin hut! Together, chin up, eyes in the prize, forward, march! Military Academy is where he should be sent. We'll drill this linnet right out of his head, I'm sure we'll make a dent. We'll teach him fighting and left and righting until he's muscle and ten. A hut, two, three, athletic, a hut, two, three, unathletic, a hut, two, three, but I'm betting we can. The military, that's what makes a boy a man. Here. Why you wouldn't know is just a few months ago, this one was slumming in the shower. This one couldn't color within the lines. And this one actually had an opinion. All boys believe in the right of every who to eat their bread. Butter side up. If there's one thing we trust on this fragile speck of dust, is eating their bread. Butter side up. As for those who lack their bread buttered down, who will go to war and run them out of town. Listen, and our system and boys soon see nothing's easier than the military. That's what makes a boy. I do not like green eggs and ham.
I do not like green eggs and ham.
I do not like them semi-ham.
I do not like them semi-ham.
Sound off.
Eggs and ham.
Sound off.
Semi-ham.
I do not like green eggs and ham.
For over a week.
getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind. Because I found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, on a flower, in the air, in planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. I'm fairly certain at one point or another, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm all alone in the universe, so all alone in the universe. I found magic, but they won't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings and I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. Well, someday soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. My own planets and stars are glowing.
Alone in the universe.
No one notices anything. Not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing.
Nobody knows that I have wings.
I have wings.
And I can fly. In the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Please believe in me. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, Jojo, the mayor's son.
Well, I'm Horton, the elephant.
Are you real? Or are you a very large stick?
Oh, I'm real, all right. I'm stick, dead in ink.
Well, in my thinks, I imagine a lot of strange things. When I go to strange places, as if I had wings. I love a good think.
That goes for me double.
Sometimes my thinks are what get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
In bright colors!
Me too, and I go to strange places like Solace the Loo.
Well, when you think, do you think you could fly to the stars?
Oh, little friend, no one else could have thinks such as ours. Yes, I have wings.
I have wings.
And I can fly.
I can fly.
Around the moon and far beyond the sky. You called my name and you said,
who believes in me?
Good night, Jojo.
Oh, good night, Horton. I'll see you in Solace the Loo.
The scene's over. There's more to be heard. There goes our hero, who enters
the bird.
Love song for Horton, number 437.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
There once was a girl bird named Gertrude McFuzz, and she had the smallest, plainest tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she dyed it, she gave it a puff. She decked it with flowers, but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feathered tail of Miss Gertrude McFuzz.
Poor little Gertrude. Such a sorry sight. I'll take you under my wing and maybe you'll be all right.
I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing shore-fish, but what's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing shore-fish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
And I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
Dr. Dick by the link!
And he told me what sort of pill I should take. Now, I'm amazing. Maisie, as feathered can be now. Amazing, Maisie, it was awful sale. Amazing, Maisie, the birds are all whistling at me now. Amazing, Maisie, baby, that's my tale.
Your kind of bird.
Then Gertrude had tantrums. She raised such a din. Then finally the doctor just had to give in.
All right, already. Bring in the bellberry bush.
What was that? Something
seatbelt, cause now things go wrong.
Yeah, there's a rustle in the bushes. There's a tremble in the trees. Hear it like a whisper, smell it on the summer breeze. Something big is getting nearer. Something big is coming through. Got some monkey business, that's what we intend to do.
How lucky you are. When you're life's going wrong, when the feet's are unkind, when you're limping along and get kicked from behind. Tell yourself how lucky you are. Why decry a cloudy sky, an empty purse, a crazy universe? My philosophy is simply things could be worse.
Excuse me.
So be happy you're here. Think of life as a thrill. And if worse can seem worse, as we all know it will, thank your lucky star you've gotten this far. We're here in this beautiful theater, and you're in the first row. How lucky to be in the theater, more lucky than you know. Well, you could have the luck of our hero, whose luck has been running low for certain. Curtain! How lucky you are! How lucky you are!
That bird let that clover drop somewhere inside a great patch of clovers 100 miles wide. Oh, I'll find it or bust. I shall find my friends on their small speck of dust. Yes, clover, by clover with care, I'll call and I'll listen. Are you there? Are you there? Are you there? Are you there?
All my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor behind the facade of your awkward next door neighbor. My eyes are too small, I have very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful. But I've now got a tail that is something to see.
102, 103.
Oh, notice me hoarding feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me hoarding together. We could be gray. Oh, notice me hoarding.
Put down the clover.
Your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf. Your neighbor's turned over.
Over and over, clover by clover.
I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something more. Are you there? $2,999,999. Oh, it's hopeless. You said it, kid.
What? Who's there?
It's me, Maisie, up here.
Maisie, are you on a nest?
You want to make something of it?
No, no, I never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I. I'm stout and fort worth, just a girl on the wing. When I met you, we'd make verse. Who could that night out sing? Tell yourself how lucky you are. It was 3 weeks of bliss, then the usual sang. He flew off to San Juan, leaving me with this egg. Tell yourself how lucky you are. Now I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, and day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation, come do but some rest. Hey ho, would you make me like to sit on my nest?
Why, Maisie, I couldn't of all silly things. I haven't got feathers, I haven't got wings. And what's more, right now, I'm here on a search. I couldn't just leave my poor who's in a lurch.
Oh, Horton, please, I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise, I'll fly back real soon. I'd only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg and try not to break it. But please come back quickly. 1 hour, maybe two. I've got to find JoJo. I've got to save who?
Hit it, cat. Thanks, a million. Then Horton the elephant smiled.
Now that's that.
And he sat and he sat and he sat and he sat. He sat all that day and he kept the egg warm. And he sat all that night through a terrible
cold and I'm wet, and I'm catching the flu. No, Maisie, please hurry, I've got to save who? Oh, Maisie, please hurry, I've got to save who?
I brought you a scarf.
Oh, thanks, Gertrude. Do you know where Maisie went?
She sent a postcard from Palm Beach.
Palm Beach? Gertrude, what if she never gets back?
Oh, don't worry, she will. Horton, notice anything different?
Yeah, it's getting colder. I said what I meant, and I meant what I said. This egg might get frozen, but the who's might be dead. I couldn't say no when I heard Maisie beg. Now I'm caught between a dust speck and an incubating egg. Oh no! Hunters! Help! Help! When your life's going wrong and you're wondering why.
When your tail is so long you're unable to fly.
Tell yourself how lucky you are.
When you land with a thud and you're bumped and you're bruised.
Trapped.
You're grabbed.
and confused, tell yourself how lucky you are. Why rehash a nasty crash? Why call a hearse or curse the universe? My philosophy is simply, things could be worse. So be happy you're here, think of life as a thrill.
Which means that one is through!
So go, have a nice intermission! Oh, Bobby's a real zoo. But we've gotta fix the stage and get ready to play act two.
So tell yourself how lucky you are!
How lucky! The moment you've all been waiting for. Without further ado, presenting act...
Wait! What happens to Horton? Will this Horton get free? Will this Horton find Jojo?
There's no guarantee.
Will the egg be okay?
Well, I'll give you a clue. When act one is done, what happens?
Act two!
When we last saw our hero, he was hopelessly trapped.
Shoot if you must, but I won't run away. No matter what happens, I said I would stay.
And the Who's all crashed and their whole town was scrapped.
We're lost on the clover. We need to be found. Sir, why do we keep on just marching around?
And Gertrude was helpless. I think you know why. Her tail was so long, she could no longer fly. And so, our story resumes on that terrible day, as Horton gets carried
away.
Up out of the jungle, up into the sky, then over the mountain,
10,000 feet high, then down from the mountain, then down to the sea, went Horton the elephant, head nest and tree. Out over the ocean and through what a trip, through
Gentlemen, and welcome to Sousby's. Our first item up for bid is Lot 463, a pendulous pachyderm on Agnes and Tree. We will start the bidding for this lovely item at $10,000. Here, do I hear $10,000? Oh, $10,000. All right, do I hear 15? 15, oh, 15, thank you. 20, thank you. Do I hear 30, thank you. Oh, do I hear 50,000? 50,000, 50,000, 50,000, thank you, to the front row. 100,000, 1,000,000. Oh, thank you. 2 million, 2 million, 5 million, 7, you are a rich audience. Do I hear $1 trillion? Oh, do I hear $3 billion? Up in the back to the man in the black mustache and the greasy sideburns and, oh. I'm sorry, young lady. I'm sold to the man from the circus.
Gentlemen, children and creatures, from the smallest to the small, to the tallest of the tall, come one, come all, to the Circus McGurkus, the world's greatest show on the face of the earth, or wherever you go. It's the Circus McGurkus in town for 1 week. Why, each marvelous marvel is just 10 cents a peek. Oh, the sights that you'll see, why, our big top is packed, and there's no telling where we may find our next act.
Along on a
throat full of ruts, getting jeered by a throng and performing for nuts. Tell yourself how lucky you are. There's a crick in your tail and a cramp in your toes. You're on who knows what trail and where who is who knows. Tell yourself how lucky you are. I'm worried for JoJo and all of the rest. They're lost on the clover, I'm stuck on this nest. I'll stay on this egg, cause what else can I do? Oh Maisie, please find me, vacation is through. Oh Maisie, please hurry, I've got to save who?
Down in Palm Beach with a breeze in your hair, and you don't have an egg or a nest or a care. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
When it's day after day, after beautiful day, to be laid then away by the sea with Jose. Cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required for nothing but play? I need something different, I crave something new. Hey, maybe could you think of something different to do? A circus? I love a show. I think I'll go. Before. Now let's see.
Why, Maisie, remember, it's Horton. It's me. I've sat in your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through thunder and hailstorms and snow. Won't you take your egg back?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh, wow, it's really late. Gee, I got a date and lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you. Such a big success. And it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, that exiting circus sensation. Amazing Horton, even I'm impressed. Amazing. Off taking vacation, you made your fortune upon Maisie's nest. I may be unreliable, fancy free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager to fly. Something right. The egg is all yours. No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck. And goodbye.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%. Be
left up to me. A fool of an elephant up in a tree. This time I swear I'd better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby. There's a faraway land, so the stories all tell, somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few. Someday we'll go to Salazalu. Salazalu,
Salazalu, Salazalu.
I've lost my poor boots, and we've traveled so far. Oh, Jojo, forgive me, wherever you are.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm thinking of you and wishing we all were in Salazalu. They say breezes are warm there.
And people are kind.
Maybe it's something like heaven. I close my eyes and I see in my mind skies of bluest blue. Salazalu.
I had so much trouble finding my way there. When I get close, it
disappears.
If we can get there, we're gonna stay there. If it takes a smile.
If it takes a smile.
High on a mountain or lost on the sea.
Sooner or later, I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be.
On the day I do, troubles will be through. And I'll be home with you. Salazalu. Sound off, sound off, I do not like green eggs and ham. We've arrived at the war, as I said that we would, and war is a thing that does every boy good. We will sleep in the trenches and go without supper to make the world safe. Each butter side other. And we'll shoot every traitor and all out of tatters. You side with those bibulous Butterside Downers. Any questions?
Sir, this war makes no sense. Well, just one think and you'd quit. Spreading bread up or down doesn't matter a bit. We've crashed on the clover and there's no help in sight. So why are you here teaching children to fight? Well, not only that, sir, but it's Christmas on who? And I'd rather have Christmas than war, wouldn't you? So here is my sword, and here is my hat. I'm going home, and that, sir, is that.
It's a minefield out there. This is no time for play.
Sir, I think what I think. Now get out of my way.
Soldier, you will obey. You will halt. Jojo, come back. Son, wait.
Puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so?
It came without ribbons.
It came without tags.
It came without packages, boxes, or bags.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then?
Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's heart grew three sizes that day.
And he brought back the toys, and he brought back the food for the feast. And he himself...
He caught the Grinch caught the roast beast. Beast,
he
caught the beast.
What?
Thank you, Mr. Grinch. As always, a wonderful Christmas show. And may I just say we're most grateful this year. We've all had such trouble, much trouble, I fear. We've crashed on a clover, things smashed and things tore. Our town is a mess and our plan is at war. But it hasn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, somehow or other, it came just the same. So let's make a toast that the war won't arrive here, that Horton will find us and we'll all stay alive here.
And here's to our Jojo, our sweet, precious son, who's still off at school and I'm sure having fun.
A message from the front!
Battle of Butter, your son, lost.
Lost?
The battle began, paid great cost.
Oh no.
He did not want to fight, and he may have been right. Here's his sword and his hat. Regrets and good night.
Reenactment!
how mine feel now? Is it no time for play?
Sir, I think what I think. Now get out of my way.
Soldier, you will halt. Soldier, wait. Soldier, you will obey.
A hunch you should follow your nose. Then you have a sudden hunch you should follow your toes. Soon a sneaky hunch is whispering, better go safe. And before you know it, out so late, 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 late,
late, late, late, late.
Now a nervous hunch is telling you you could be lost.
Lost, 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 lost.
As it leads you down a path you have already crossed. Soon you're overwhelmed by hunches that pester and pinch and punch. And you know you're having a hunch.
You're having a hunch. You're having a hunch. You're having a hunch. You're having a hunch.
And oh, the places you'll go.
I got brains in my head and feet in my shoes.
So steer yourself any direction you choose. And oh, the places you'll go. Set your hunches free to wander and follow them where they roam. And
follow your hunch,
follow it.
Follow your hunch,
follow your hunch. Follow it.
Follow your hunch.
Follow it. Follow it home.
Anything's possible.
I mean, everyone does, but Gertrude did something that few birds could do. So, this is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part two. Psst! What? Horn, are you there?
What? Who is it?
It's me, Gertrude.
Gertrude, how did you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little. It was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying.
Go on.
Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I'd been foolish because I couldn't even help. You know, I couldn't even fly. And I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was going to go to all the labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dick, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dick, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out. Get it off. I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feather tail.
quite suddenly, Gertrude could sail.
I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk. I trampled through the trees full of furious bees. For you. I saw through a bog in a choking smog, down a soggy slope, through a stinking bog, while my slip was gripped by a vicious dog. For you. I galloped through the snow in 11 below. For you. Yes, even though I knew I was catching the blue. For you.
I never noticed, but you're amazing.
Oh, it was nothing.
Hello? Hello, who? Is anyone there?
Hello?
Oh, what a relief. Why, hello, Mr. Mayor. Is Jojo all right?
Hi, Horton.
Oh, hello, Jojo. Kid, now that I got you, I won't let you go. I'll shelter and guard you, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
Oh, how happy and sweet, but our tale is not over.
Oh, yeah, it is too. Get me down from this clover.
I'm sorry, but there's no happy ending in sight. So all I can say is, hey, Jojo, hold tight.
Ha! 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 How did you get here?
You can't run away from a sack kangaroo. Palm Beach to Pittsburgh to Kalamazoo. Have you with your egg and your tree and your nest? I'm making a sound that is so red.
No!
Taking you back. You're gonna be going inside. For talking to his back and sitting on an egg.
You're gonna be.
Gonna be.
Gonna be.
Gonna be put on trial.
This is the case of the people versus Horton the elephant.
Horton the elephant.
Judge Yellowtail to preside and everyone cries.
Order, order, order in the court.
Order, 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 order in the court.
The defendant is charged with talking to a speck, disturbing the peace, and loitering on an egg.
Your Honor, this clover is Exhibit A. There's who's here. There are who's here. Smaller than the eye can
see. He's playing fool in the jungle now.
True, sir. Here's who, who's, sir. He's a who and so is.
He's playing fool in the jungle now.
Order, order, order in the court.
Call for the stand, the star witness versus on the elephant. Raise your right hand and swear.
Long ago, fierce, blameful, just a fool, and a mother.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%. You can throw me in jail, lock me up in the zoo, but I won't desert my egg, and I will not abandon who. Whether you believe or not, they're here, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do with me what you want, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
On the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the Elephant, remanded to the Mule Asylum for the criminally insane. And as for your dust bag,
and as for your dust bag,
and as for your dust bag, now we will boil.
No, that you can't do. It's all full of persons. They'll prove it to you. Mr. Mayor, Mr. Mayor, oh please, Mr. Mayor, you have to prove now that you really are there. You ring every doorbell and send out the word. Make every who holler, make every who heard.
Boil, 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 boil!
Attention all who's, attention all who's.
Well, we've got to be heard,
there's no time to lose.
So send them a shout.
Make it loud, make it clear.
We are here, we are here.
Now surely you heard, it was clear as a bell. Now surely you all heard that very well.
I heard no small voices, and you didn't either.
Boil it! Boil it!
Boil it!
Boil it!
Boil it!
Boil it!
Boil it!
Boil it!
Don't give up. I believe in you all. A person's a person, no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard. So please, try.
Boil it! Boil it! Boil it!
Now, just for a moment, young JoJo looked grim. The fate of the Who's rested squarely on him. But then came a think, a peculiar new word, the kind of a think no one ever had heard.
We are here! We are here!
We are here!
We are here!
We are here.
I mean, they made themselves heard, though they still can't be seen.
They proved they really are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true is how true, said the sour kangaroo. But from now on, you know what I'm planning to do. From now on, I'm going to protect them with you.
Their troubles were over. They hailed his great.
Yeah!
And JoJo was honored as thinker nonstop.
Now all JoJo's thinks would forever be heard.
Including this think.
Except for the wings.
And except for the voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Gertrude, what will I do? I'm slow, and I'm fat. All I know is earth. He'll need much more than that.
I have wings. Yes, I can fly.
troubles... Our troubles were over. The sky became...
pink!
And then guess what happened?
Well, what do you think?
Oh, the things you can think and wonder and dream, far and wide as you dare. When your things have run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, all the things you will find, lining up together. Not in a tree, you let me be. I do not like me.